Now what we're going to do is we're going to put some canvas on it. And that's the final step. So what you need is a pretty decent staple gun. Your canvas. Cut enough canvas that you have enough to... I like to wrap mine around to the back. So I cut enough so that I can wrap it around the back like this. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to start from the center here. I'm going to go over to the other side. For the benefit of for you, I'll just flip this around. Pull it nice and tight. What I'm using today, I'm using pre-gessoed canvas. Normally I like to use ungessoed canvas so I can have more control over the surface that I'm going to use. Now that I have the centers done like this, now what I want to do is work my way into the corners. I'm going to work my way into the corners. Do this enough to get that ninja grip. Now we'll work this corner. I'm going to go to the opposite side. And do that so that, say if this wasn't as well built as this, keep it from flexing all over the place. But we have a strong stretcher, so we don't have to worry about that. The reason why I like to do it on the outside from the back is that I like a nice outside edge without staples. So if I decide I don't want to put a frame on it, I have a nice outside edge. Now, as I work my corners into the corner here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make almost like with the hospital corners. I'm going to bring the canvas in like this and then bring it back over. Put a nice crease on it, so I have like a 45 degree angle on this, and it gives you a nice corner. And I'll staple that. Basically, that's what I'll end up with. Now I'm going to go ahead and finish, and I'll show you the end product. This is the finished product. It has the corners, the hospital corners on it, nice, clean corners. No staples running down the edge. The only thing that I would do now is just spray a little water on the back, and putting water on the back will take this canvas and stretch it and tighten it even further. So But basically, you have a nice stretcher to work on, nice surface to paint on. You have the nice corners here, the quarter rounds, so that as you're painting, you won't have the edge of the canvas showing through. It's up high enough, so you can really work on this canvas and produce a nice piece of work. So now it's just up to you to go ahead and start painting and produce that nice work of art. And what better type of canvas to work on? Especially since we have biscuits in the corners. Take care, this is Ray Horner. Hope you enjoyed this episode of how to build a stretcher and also to stretch your canvas. Thank you for your time and your patience. And the only last thing I will say, happy painting. Enjoy yourself. This is the next project that we're going to work on. It's an easel. I mean, since we went ahead and made the stretcher and stretched our canvas, what better project next than to build your own easel? And it's really inexpensive. You can build one of these easels for roughly about $25. So, this is our next project. Hope to see you soon. Enjoy.